You are welcome to Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope.
AWR Ghana, Voice of Hope. Voice of
Hope. This is Daylight Magazine. Welcome, my wonderful listener, to Children's Hour. Today, we have a wonderful package for you, and God will surely bless you if you stay tuned in to the end of this program. I am your presenter, Alfred Balisasa. Stay with us, for your blessing is on the way. World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope.
AWR Ghana, Voice of Hope.
This is Daylight Magazine. On today's program, we have memory verses,
story time,
life songs, a moment of truth.
We will bring you joy, keep hope alive.
My name is Sajima Opokwerika. My memory verse is taken from Psalm 18, verse 1. I will praise you, O Lord, my strength in me.
My name is Michael. My memory verse is taken from 1 John chapter 4, verse 7. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And he that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. Amen.
My name is Gifty. I'm 7 years old. My memory verse is taken from Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
My name is Mami Sewa. I am 7 years old. My memory verse is, we are looking forward to a new heaven. 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 30. Amen.
My name is Gifty. I'm 7 years old. My memory verse is taken from Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
My name is Ajima Opokwerika. My memory verse is taken from Psalm 18 verse 1. I will praise you, O Lord, my strength. Amen.
My name is Ajima Opokwerika. My memory verse is taken from Psalm 18 verse 1. I will praise you, O Lord, my strength. Amen.
You are tuned into Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope.
AWR, Voice of Hope, we will bring you joy, keep hope alive.
Stay tuned in while we present to you
Story Time,
Live Songs, A Moment of Truth.
Every promise in the book is mine. Every chapter, every verse, every line. All the blessings of His love divine.
Hello children, how are you today?
We are fine, thank you.
Today we have another beautiful time for beautiful storytelling. We're going to listen to a very wonderful and a very interesting story. And the title of this story is The Motherless Child. The Motherless Child. Once upon a time, there lived a man with his wife. And for a long time, the woman didn't have a child. But later, God blessed her, and she had a girl. And this girl was very beautiful. But unfortunately, the mother died, leaving the daughter, that is her child, and then the father. The two of them, father and the daughter, were left alone. The mother was gone. And so to take care of this girl, the father decided to marry another woman. The woman he married had a daughter. And when she came to the house of the husband, she brought her daughter. So how many girls are in the house now?
Two
girls, right. One belongs to the man. The other belongs to the woman. Right. So this woman, who is now the wife of the man, took very good care of her own daughter, leaving the daughter of the man. And one day, the two girls had a kind of sickness or disease we called yaws. Yaws is like boils. You know boils? Like pimples, big ones, and they cover all the body, all over your body, very painful, and then pus, that's a kind of water like milk, will be coming out of the the boils, and it's very painful. And so to treat it, you have to give a bath. That's bath, the wash the person, the diseased person, very hard, and then put some spirit, some hot ointment on it so that the yours will heal. So what the woman did was to take a kind of broken bottle to scrape the yours of the other girl who wasn't her own daughter, very hard, very painfully. And that was the better way to treat the yours. And so when she would do that, she would now apply very hot ointment, and the girl would cry. But her own child, she would wash her very gently, and the girl could not cry. And when she would finish, she would put something soft, some soft ointment on the yours. So the other girl, whose yours were treated painfully, got healed, and she became better. But the woman's own daughter, because she was treating her gently, softly, the yours could not heal, so the girl died. Right. Now, the man, that's the husband, didn't understand, and he asked the woman, why is that the two girls in the house, they got the same disease? One is healed, the other is not healed. But even before this time, that girl whose yours was healed became a beautiful woman and was married to a king. A king then married her, and she was very happy. So after this, the father came and asked the woman, why is it that the other girl died and this one didn't die? So in a shame, the woman said, I treated this girl mercilessly. I thought that I was trying to hurt her so that I would kill her. I didn't know that I was doing her good. And I treated my own daughter very softly and gently so that she would not be hurt. I didn't know that I was doing her great harm. And so that's why my daughter died. Right. So now, children, you've seen what this woman has done. You know, she thought that she was doing good to her own daughter and doing bad to the other girl who wasn't her daughter. And that saved the other girl. And what she did to her own daughter killed her daughter. So what lesson do we learn from this wonderful story? Esther?
I've learned that we should not do as if the thing you are doing for your own child is good.
Okay, thank you very much indeed. Yeah, Elam?
I've learned that we shouldn't be wicked.
You've learned that we shouldn't be wicked. That's good. Right. Kofi?
I learned that we should not pity the only ones we know.
We should not pity only the people we know, our friends. That's good. Right. Yes, Emanuela?
I've learned that if somebody's wife is dead and they've left their child and they marry another woman, the woman shouldn't just take care of her own daughter and leave the other one. She will save the other one and let her own daughter die.
Okay, thank you very much indeed. Right.
I learned that always, if we see people, even if they are poor and we are rich, we should love them and share our things with them.
Very good. We should share our things with all people, whether poor or rich. Right. Kofi again.
I learned that we should do good to everyone.
We should do good to everyone. Is that okay?
Yes.
Yes, we should do good to everyone. Yes, David.
I learned that when we are doing wicked things to others, even if it may seem wicked to us, we may be doing good to those who we think are doing wicked.
Okay, that is good. That is good. Did you hear, David?
Yes.
Yeah? Did you?
Yes.
Right, good. Yes. Hello again.
I've learned that we should love and treat our neighbors as ourselves.
We should love and treat other people like ourselves. Right. Does anybody know the golden rule? Yeah, who knows it? The golden rule, yes.
It says, do what you want other people to do to you.
Okay. Do unto others as you want them to do to you. What you want other people to do to you, if you want them to treat you very well, you also treat other people very well. When we do that, there will be peace. All right. And, right. So this wicked woman didn't do well at all. By doing harm to the other girl, she saved her. And by doing what she's supposed to be good to her own child, she killed her own child, right? So this is what we have learned, and it's good. Let us pray with Mauli.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, please God, thank you for all what you've done for us. Please God, thank you for letting us listen to this message. And please God, help us to learn a lesson from it and abide by it so that it will be well with us. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
You have been listening to Daylight Magazine, coming from Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope. If you need further information or study materials on issues we have discussed, please contact us on Adventist World Radio Ghana, VVU PO Box AF 595, Adenta, Accra, Ghana, West Africa. Or if you have access to the internet, send us an email through radio@vvu.edu.gh, or better still, you can call us on +233 307 051 058. The number again, +233 307 051 058. If our line is busy, don't give up trying, for we are expecting your calls, emails, and letters.
AWR, Voice of Hope. We will bring you joy. Keep hope alive.
And be glad in you.
Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you.
Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you.
Let such as love your salvation.
Your salvation.
Continually. Let such as love your salvation.
It's time to listen to the Word of God. Stay tuned in while we present to you Moments of Truth.
Hello, children. This is Pastor Israel, and I'm so happy to be with you on today's program, Moment of Truth. And today we are talking about one of my favorite people. I want you to guess. Well, I'll give you three guesses. This person is in the Old Testament of the Bible. He was the 11th child of his parents. Well, let me just help you. His name is Joseph. You know, Joseph was a very young child who was born into the midst of brothers. He had so many brothers. You may have thought he had two brothers like you have two brothers, or maybe three brothers like you have three brothers, or some of you have sisters. But Joseph was born into a family of, guess what? 11 brothers. 11 brothers. He was number 11, and he had a younger brother whose name was Benjamin, who was number 12. So Joseph, even though he was number 11, was the favorite of his father. You know, it's not cool for daddy to love some children more than other children. And if you think that your daddy loves your brother or your sister or, you know, somebody more than you, I think it should be something you should talk about with daddy and not just get so upset and angry like Joseph's brothers were. You know, Joseph's daddy, whose name was Daddy Jacob, sent Joseph on an errand to go and give some food to his brothers. And his brothers were so upset with him. You know, one thing that I learned from that is that the fact that someone does something to you does not necessarily mean that you have to kill them because you don't like the way they are. You can talk to them. You can explain your position. You can, you know, help them see what makes you upset about what they do. But Joseph's big brothers decided they were going to kill him. And they dragged him when he brought the food, got the food from him, took off his coat that his daddy had bought for him, and threw him in a pit. You know, it's interesting that it was while Joseph was in the pit that he began to change his mind about his attitude and began to say, God, please, if you help me get out of this hole, I will no longer be proud. I will no longer be arrogant. I will not be disrespectful to my older brothers. I'll be a nice young man. Actually, I'm going to give my life to Jesus. And that is exactly what Joseph did when God brought him out of the pit. You can find this story written in your Bible, Genesis 37. Genesis 37, the whole chapter talks about how Joseph got himself into trouble. But you know, Joseph was also known as someone who had a dream, who had a vision. And the dream and the vision that Joseph had was such that he believed that God was going to make him a ruler in the next few years. Joseph didn't know how that was going to happen because the environment where he was growing up, there were only about 60 people in the whole place. So how can you be a king over 60 people? But you know, because he had the dream, the Bible says that his father kept this dream in his heart. So Joseph was thrown in the pit. He prayed. God should help him. God got him out of the pit. And he was now sold away into slavery. And Joseph went into the land of Egypt. And while he was there, he was a slave in the house of Potiphar. And it was in Potiphar's house that he learned how to be a better servant. You know, in his father's house, he was a servant serving his brothers. But in Potiphar's house, he was a servant over many servants. He became a better servant. And it was in this place that he was able to show that everything that his parents had taught him from home was good and he can use it for God's glory. Mrs. Potiphar came to him one day and said, Joseph, you know, I like you a lot because you are a handsome young man. You are nice looking. You know, everything about you is so nice. Why don't we go to bed together? You know, he was talking to Joseph about sex. And Joseph said, no way. I'm not going to do that because if I do that, I'm not sinning just against your husband. I'm sinning against God. And Joseph told her that every day. But one day, she caught him in the house and said, you must go to bed with me today. You must have sex with me today. And Joseph ran, left his coat with her, and he ran. And she lied against him. You know, this is the second time some people will do bad things to Joseph. Even though she lied against him, some people believed her more than Joseph, and he was put in prison. First, he was put in a pit. Secondly, he was sold into slavery in Potiphar's house. Thirdly, he was put in prison for nothing that he did. But guess what? It was while he was in prison that God recognized him, showed him to somebody who told the king about him, and Joseph was promoted. So what is the point of this whole time that we've had together for the last few minutes? The point is, if there are some things in your life that God is telling you you need to get rid of, you better get rid of it before you are thrown into a pit like Joseph. And even if you find yourself in a pit, you are in a difficult position because of your attitude, your pride, your arrogance, talk to God about it and say, God, please help me. I don't want to be proud. I don't want to be arrogant. I don't want to be disrespectful. Give me a good heart so that I can respect and love others around me. And God will get you out of that pit of the bad attitude. God helped Joseph. God can help you too. God took Joseph to the house of Potiphar, took him through that to the prison, and finally to the palace. Whatever dreams you have, God can make you happy. Well, it was nice spending time with you. God bless you. Until I see you next time, this is Pastor Israel saying goodbye.
Tune in to Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope. This is Daylight Magazine.
AWR Ghana, Voice of Hope. Voice of
Hope. You have been listening to Daylight Magazine, coming from Adventist World Radio Ghana, Voice of Hope. If you need further information or study materials on issues we have discussed, please contact us on Adventist World Radio Ghana, VVU PO Box AF 595, Adenta, Accra, Ghana, West Africa. Or if you have access to the internet, send us an email through radio@vvu.edu.gh. Or better still, you can call us on +233 307 051 058. The number again, +233 307 051 058. If our line is busy, don't give up trying, for we are expecting your calls, emails, and letters. Today's program was presented by Alfred Balisasa. May God bless you.